Hello everybody and welcome to Paracrew. Today I'm going to be reviewing the DeskLab portable monitor. This monitor is on the premium end of the market and among other things boasts high brightness, a touchscreen, and integrated speakers. Before we begin, let me note that DeskLab was kind enough to send me over this unit to review, but as always this video contains only my genuine thoughts and impartial opinion on the monitor. Now that we've got that out of the way, let us take a look at the specs. The DeskLab monitor comes in 1080p and 4K resolution variants. These currently retail for $299 and $399 US dollars respectively. Both of them sport a glossy IPS panel with a typical 60Hz refresh rate and have a 20 milliseconds response time. The monitor is compatible with a wide range of devices, including laptops, desktop computers, tablets, mobile phones, and gaming consoles, including the Nintendo Switch, even without the dock. Keep in mind, however, that touch compatibility on some configurations, such as macOS laptops, is limited. In my testing, the touchscreen worked fine on both my Windows desktop and laptop computer, and on my Android devices. The packaging is fairly minimal. Inside the box, aside from the monitor itself, we find a manual, along with an HDMI cable, and a USB Type-C to Type-C cable, which is everything you need to set it up. Keep in mind that the magnetic kickstand cover is sold separately, and if you do decide to get the monitor, I advise you also get the cover, as it makes the setup more usable. Alternatively, a stand for a large tablet might also do the trick. In the build quality department, everything is on par with what you would expect from a portable monitor in the premium price range. The glossy glass panel looks and feels great. I was pleasantly surprised to find out that during use, the glass isn't very noticeable and that the glass collects way fewer finger smudges than I expected. The aluminum alloy frame is sturdy, has narrow side bezels, discreet branding, and clear markings for the I/O ports. The monitor is quite slim, measuring just 6mm at the thinnest point, and it weighs around 0.5kg. The magnetic stand cover is made of a durable textured pleather material and looks quite stylish. It has strong magnets on the back to hold onto the monitor and supports it quite well, even on smooth surfaces. Regarding I/O, on the left side we have two USB Type-C ports used for input and power, and a full HDMI port, along with a 3.5mm audio jack for connecting headphones or external speakers. Note that if your device supports it, you can use just a single USB Type-C cable to both power the monitor and send the video signal. However, you can always use an HDMI and USB Type-C cable combination like the one I use on my desktop. On the right side, we have three buttons to navigate the OSD menu and a USB pass-through port to connect external devices like a mouse or a keyboard to your phone or computer. Moving to functionality, the monitor has an OSD menu that will allow you to adjust brightness, contrast, sharpness, switch color profiles, enable dynamic contrast ratio, and it also has FreeSync and HDR support, which are nice to have for gaming and movies. The monitor gets quite bright, probably brighter than any other portable monitor I've seen. The viewing angle is also quite good, as expected from an IPS panel. Colors feel quite accurate and cover a large portion of the sRGB spectrum, making the monitor suitable for creative work for all you photo and video editors on the go. The display also has integrated dual speakers on the back, which are surprisingly better than anticipated and are quite usable in portable situations. While testing the monitor, I've used it with my laptop and mobile devices, but I find myself using it more and more on my desktop setup as well. The monitor can be used as a display on the side or an under display, which is quite convenient during video editing. You can also use the monitor vertically, which is quite convenient for programming, but you will probably have to find a way to safely prop it up without it slipping, since the cover can't do much as a vertical kickstand. After a few weeks of use, I find myself considering using the DeskLab monitor more often. I use it on my desktop setup when working on tasks that require extra screen real estate or touch controls, and then I just easily fold it away when I need some more desk space. I also considered taking it on my vacations and using Samsung Dex with it for some on-the-go productivity tasks, ditching my laptop. Finally, in my experience, the DeskLab monitor is a great laptop companion as well, especially if your laptop supports using the monitor with a single USB Type-C cable. Overall, I really enjoy using the DeskLab monitor. It's slim, slick, well-built, and highly functional. It does come with a slightly premium price tag, but it does offer good value, especially for people who need a color-accurate portable monitor for on-the-go use. The only thing I wish DeskLab did differently with this monitor was to have the magnetic cover included. So, if you decide to pick up one for yourself, I highly recommend adding the cover to your order. So, that was it for this review, everybody. Let me know what you think of the DeskLab monitor in the comments section below. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more awesome videos coming your way soon. I'll see you all in the next one.